Hi, my name is Idan Speiser. I am the founder of 911 Restoration Franchise. We are a water, mold, fire damage cleanup and restoration franchise. Today, we have about 300 units, 300 territories that we are serving around the country and growing into Canada. So how did we get to where we are today? So as you hear my accent, I'm not from here originally. Moved to the US around 2000-2001 with about $1,000 and a broken English. Came here with the dream of, the American dream. Money grows on the trees. Every house comes with a pool and all that that we used to see in the Hollywood movies. Arrived here, discovered that I need to put a lot of work in. It's not as easy as it seems that it is. Started as a carpet cleaner, did that for about a year. Through the carpet cleaning, I learned about the restoration industry. Knew nothing about blowers or dehumidifiers or any of it. But as we're doing the carpet cleaning or extracting the water from a flood, I got to see what other restoration companies are doing out there. And one of the things that really hit me when I saw it is the lack of good customer experience. I saw companies coming in, creating this big mess, pulling carpet walls, setting up blowers, dehumidifiers, getting the customer to sign this 10 pages document while not really paying attention to the emotional situation of the customer. The customer in through his experience is losing his biggest assets. If some mom needs to take her kids to school and she now needs to deal with the kids and breakfast and the flood and everything that comes with it. So my goal was to really understand the customer needs and create a very unique customer experience. So that's one of the things that really opened my eyes and kind of saw the opportunities within the restoration company. The second part that happened around 2003 is the ability to generate leads through online lead generation. So before I got into the restoration industry and before I knew about the ability to generate lead through Google and many other sources, well, we averaged about $250,000 a year. And once we discovered that, we grew to over $3 million in revenue in about a year and a half. That led me to really understand that there's many, many opportunities out there in entrepreneurship, right? Having the freedom, kind of creating my own future was something that was really real for me. It's something that I wanted to pursue. So I decided to go and build my own business. That led me to respond to Katrina when the big floods happened at the end of 2005 in New Orleans. Went out there at that point, I had many trucks and equipment and on. But one of the things that kind of opened my eyes is me working with many other restoration company. And what I noticed is that many of the owners are great people. They just really care about the trade itself. So they care about, the walls, the drywalls, the carpet, the how to set up the vent and on. And my big passion was around customer experience, creating strategy. How can I get people to work together? How can we build something that is meaningful and impactful? And that led me to collaborate with other restoration companies. And I started with about 10 companies, and that led me into the franchise world. And I saw that it's working very, very well. So from 10, we kept scaling and growing, and this is where we are today. One of the things that I learned is kind of going on my journey, again, without any business experience, don't have any business degree, just really learning from working with people and, just being out there. Is long-term thinking, right? We way too often, we overestimate what we can do in 1 year, but we underestimate what we can do in 10 or 15 years. This is where we are today, right? So long-term thinking really gets you to be more proactive than reactive, right? You're following a plan, you understand what is important to you. So that was a big lesson for me. Once I understand that I need to look at things more as a long-term and have more of the proactive mindset, everything got to be much, much easier, and it's helped me really build a great team around me. The second part is, I spent too many years trying to get better at areas that is not really my skill, is not really part of my innate abilities. Each one of us have things that come very easily to you. So instead of doubling down on my my innate abilities, I spent too many years trying to get better in other areas. And once I kind of learned that and understand that, and I start to double down on my abilities, I was able to build a great momentum in the business. And also I was able to build a great team around me. And I gave them the space and I gave them the freedom to create within the company while we hold each other accountable to the goals and the result that we need to create to be able to achieve our goals. So being proactive, not reactive, was a big one. And the second one is really understanding who is the team that I need to build around me and what's the importance of holding each other accountable. Mistakes in the business, you know, we made many mistakes. You know, if it's not the hiring the right person, changing the way we are communicating with our franchisees, better understanding the support system, understanding that different businesses have different needs based on their growth. So, of course, I mean, that's part of the learning curves. And when you really think long term, that really helps you. I think the franchise space is an amazing space. As a franchisor, I really enjoy and really love seeing new franchisees coming in, different backgrounds, different mindset, while everybody is really under the same vision and mission. It's very, very powerful. Now, it's very important if you're thinking to join a franchise. You know, many people making this decision in joining a franchise through how much money they can make. But I think there is a better way of looking at it, because at one point, once you make enough money, you understand that it's more about fulfillment than money. It's more about being impactful with your team, with your community. So really choosing a franchise that is aligned with your goals, with your vision for your own life, and also understanding your abilities. Do you need to be more on the sales side? Do you need to be more on the operation side? Are you the type of person that want to build a team around you? Maybe you're just a solo entrepreneur. Right. So I will invite you to think about these things and see that it's really aligned and look at it more as a long term game. Right. If this is something that I'm going to do over the next 7 years, 14 years, 20 years, is this is something that I want to leave for my kids or for my family? Is this is a business that I'm looking to sell? So it's good to ask yourself those questions, consult with the franchise opportunity and see that really it's aligned with you. Overall, I think franchising is a great place to be. The benefits, the upside, the brand name, and many other things that come with it. And another big part that we are discovering the importance of it every year, the culture, is being surrounded by other franchisees, other business owners that want you to be successful. This is how you know that you are part of a great franchise system. Thank you very much.